What is going on, everybody? We are back with the NBA 2K24 Kyrie Irving Build My Career mode. Here in the second episode, we are going to be doing my second career game. It's going to be the first career home game. If you have yet to see the first episode, make sure to go check that out. It's in the playlist on my profile. We're just here chilling in the backstage area. We're about to head out onto the court. In a couple seconds here, you got the mascot right there. We have some quests here. We're going to check those out after the game. Might do one or two. We'll see. We're just going to go through those. Haven't gone through them yet. We'll go through them after the game. But, we're just going to head out onto the court now and get our second career game, first career home game on the road. So, as you guys see, we are taking on the Memphis Grizzlies today. I guess I'm starting at shooting guard instead of point guard, which is fine. I guess that's what they have me set as. That's fine. You want some carryover between what you worked on in training camp and the start of the season. Oh, we almost get the steal there. Dude, my guy is still so slow. I did make some attribute adjustments with the VC we earned in the first game, but like I don't even remember what I upgraded, but I think it was like speed with ball and then something else, I don't know, but I could only increase it by like 2 in total, and we get a screen assist there, so making plays off, well not really off, well, off ball, but not off ball because we affected, you know what, just ignore what I'm saying. Oh, there we go. I thought I missed that. Man. If I would have missed that, oh my gosh, I would have lost my mind. But yeah, we get our first points of the game there. 1-for-1 on the day. Might just not shoot just so we get the 100%. Oh, and we get a rebound there. Just filling up the stat sheet early on in my controller. Yep, I suck. Man. Oh, there we go. Easy. Oh, yeah. I was confused for a second there. I was like, what is going on? But, yeah, my goat thing. Because he got the good ball movement 3 times. So, got the attribute boost. So, let's... We should be able to score a lot easier now. Alright, let's see how well this works. Oh, right there. All day. And should have been an and-one. Very well should have been an and-one. Alright, so I went like 1-for-6 free throws last game. Yeah. My free throw rating is just way too low. And I just suck at 2K. Maybe that's what it is. Oh, here we go. Oh, I thought I missed it. I released that way too late. Alright. We're at 6 points on the day. Oh my gosh, I just suck. I don't know what I was thinking there, man. Yeah, I got blocked like 5 times last game. And of course, that continues in the very next game. And we get subbed out. Deserved, honestly. Very much deserved. There we go, all day. Alright, we get our first assist on the game. With that dime to Mike Muscala. We got 6 points, 1 assist, 1 rebound. Here, 6 minutes to go in the second quarter. Apparently, all I have to do with this speed boost is just drive in. And yeah, it's just gonna work every time. We're up to 10 points now.
For him to the middle. Here's Muscala. Cash.
There we go. We get another dime to Mike Muscala there, getting our second assist of the game.
The Wizards need to get off a shot here. Kuzma for three.
Okay, we get an assist there. I just kind of threw it because I didn't want to get the turnover. Because there's no way I would have made that, considering I have like a negative 5 million 3-point rating as we nearly get scored on there, but we don't.
MP with it. Gafford with a screen on Bane. And here's Wright from the arc.
Oh my gosh, who is that? Was that Jordan Poole? I don't know who that was. I wasn't paying attention. I just kind of threw that. Well, we get the buzzer beater there. Well, basically the buzzer beater. 0.2 left on the clock. But we go into halftime. 50 down 51-48. I believe I have 10 or 12 points right now. How many assists do I have? 4 assists, 4 rebounds, 5 of 9 shooting. Going down just 3 points to the Grizzlies at halftime. See if we can make the big comeback in the second half. Oh, we get the steal there. Pass it to DeLon Wright. He's the one that had the buzzer beater. Not really a buzzer beater, but it was very close to being a buzzer beater at the end of the half. I thought he would get the fast break bucket, but Ja Morant caught up to him. Gafford is going to slam it home, so it doesn't matter. We get the 2 points anyways. We tie this game up.
As you watch him play, his actions on the court speak louder than words.
All right, we're going to the line again. Already 0 for 2 at the line. Let's see if we can turn it around and go 2 for 4. And nope. Probably won't happen. Let's see. 1 for 4. I'll take that. And no. Okay, that's unfortunate, but hopefully we'll get the next one. Oh, wide open, there we go. 14 points, 4 assists, 4 rebounds, 0% free throw percentage. Don't know why that's shown in the top right, but I guess it is. B minus teammate grade, doing pretty solid in our second career game. Not solid defensive wise though. Doing pretty good.
Bane finds Morant.
2 minutes.
Adams with his screen on right. Morant. 8 makes out of 15 shots. He's got.
Alright, we're down by 9. 2 minutes left to go here. If we don't score on this possession, it could be very tough to win this game. Oh, right to Kuzma, though. Drive inside, come on. And I cannot get it to go. Yeah. That's been the story of the game for me thus far. Haven't really been able to get quality looks just because my guy is just so slow. It's kind of hard to, and I did not realize I was on Jaren Jackson Jr. there, and takes advantage of the mismatch and scores on me. I probably lit up like 80 points this game, just myself defensive wise. I have not been playing good defense this game, but Kuzma gets the bucket there. We're down by what, 9 right now? Just over a minute left. We're going to have to get this ball back and we're going to have to score quick because the Grizzlies have been playing phenomenal this quarter. And as you can see, just how phenomenal they have been. They have been scoring at will this quarter, basically. So we got to try and get a 3 here. Oh, Avdija. There we go. Okay. Okay. We get the assist there. Down by 8. We got a foul. Come on. We got a foul. What are we doing? Okay. not ideal to send John Morant to the line, but we really we still have one more foul to give. Okay. For Ja Morant. I think it would be impossible to Well, I guess we're not going to foul for some reason. I guess it's probably is better strategy to try and get a stop here. I don't know. I'm not the most basketball knowledgeable person. Yeah. Probably should have fouled there. Yeah, we got to score quick. Come on. Yeah, I cannot get anything going. My guy is way too slow. And yeah, or just shoot. Oh, okay. I'll take that. All right. Now we got a foul for sure. Come on, what are we doing? And I guess we're not fouling. Okay, so I have to run across the court to get the foul there. Not ideal to send Ja Morant to the line, but, you know, it's kind of is what it is at this point. Yeah, he hits the second one. Yeah, that's GG's. We're going to lose this game 108-117 unless we score. I'm not even going to try since they didn't want to foul. I'm not even going to try. Oh, okay. Maybe I should try because now we're only down by 6. Oh, I thought I had the steal. And yeah, I could not get the foul there. And now we foul with 1 second to go. Are you kidding me? Dude. Okay, well, maybe we can make a 6-point comeback in 7 seconds. Oh, I guess a 7-point comeback in 1.7 seconds. I think we can do it. I think it's very doable. And why are we calling timeout? There's 1.7 left. We can't do anything. And 2K CPU logic right there, man. Okay, let's see. Can we make this comeback real quick, guys? Come on, throw it to me. Oh man, almost made the comeback there. I was very, very close, almost made it. But yeah, we lose this game 119-111. Well, let me go over stats, yes. Okay, I'm just going to go over stats quick. Kyle Kuzma, 33 points, 7 rebounds, 5 assists, 13 of 21. I had 16 points, 5 rebounds, 7 assists, 8 for 14 shooting. So a lot more efficient today than game 1. 0 for 4 on free throws, but yeah. Moving forward, hopefully we improve. 0 for 2 on the season, but it is what it is. Ja Morant, he had 30 points. Jaren Jackson Jr., 23. That was enough to defeat our hopes of getting our first win of the season. But yeah, we're going to check out the quest now and see what we can do after this game. Courtside conversations after the game. Has an attachment
right,
for
I'm
us.
I'm just gonna say it. When it's all said and done, MP will be the GOAT. Unequivocally.
Unequivocally?
Unequivocally.
Well, first of all, did you just look that word up? Because I have never heard you use that word in my life.
I like to learn, so what?
Yeah, okay, fine, but you can't say that if the guy's career has just started.
I mean, yo, he's gonna be awesome.
He's incredible, but he might average 50 points a game, but what if he gets hurt?
Oh, see, man, now you're just trying to jinx him. I see what you're doing.
I'm just saying longevity is part of this conversation.
I can agree with you there. Sure.
All right, to be the GOAT, you got to do it over a long period of time.
Facts.
I get that MP's your guy, and he's amazing, no doubt, but saying that he is a lock?
Unequivocally.
That's ridiculous.
No, it's unequivocal,
it's
man.
It's ridiculous.
No, it's unequivocal. Unequivocal.
What does it mean?
It means without a doubt.
So yeah, that's what they had to say, more stuff about the whole GOAT thing, but yeah, let's check out the quest real quick. As you can see, we got the NBA ones, just the basic ones. Check out the Gatorade Gym, I'll do that another time, you know. Sunset Park, you know, it's got some basic quests here, special quests here. Got Jake from State Farm in the game again. You can get his top and bottom State Farm signature clothes by doing that. Maybe I'll have to do that. But yeah, just going through, we got the Nike endorsement deal one. I signed with Nike in the first episode, if you guys saw that. If you didn't, well, now you know. Yeah, just some, we got some daily quests here, you guys. You can get a lot of VC from these. Wow. And some Gatorade boosts as well. Might have to do those, get some VC to get some attribute boosts, but yeah, I don't know if I'm gonna do any now. Maybe, I don't know, probably not, we'll see. If not, I will try and get some in the next episode. Well, if you guys want to see them, let me know in the comments, you know, if that would be like interesting to you. You can be like, oh yeah, do some challenges or quests after a game or something like that. You can let me know in the comments if that's what you want to see. But yeah, these are the old quests, but anyways, I'm gonna end the episode off here as I run around the back locker room area. Usually the mascot is like right here, but can't go back here obviously. So if you guys made it all the way to the end, thank you guys so much for watching. You know, I really appreciate you guys sticking to the end. You know, I am very excited about doing this series, and you know, just as time goes on and my player continues to get better, I feel like it's gonna just get so much more fun to do. It already is fun to do, so just I'm really excited to continue to do this series and continue to build up my player, and just keep it going. So yeah, there's the mascot. If you made it to the end, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to check out the other episode if you haven't already. I'm going to continue to post these. I don't really have an upload schedule, but every so often. But thank you guys again for watching, and I will see you guys next time.